you know, when we start really talking about, for me, you know, the economic framework of how this country was built, and we are going into those very deep discussions around the systemic issues of economic opportunity and who gets it and who doesn't, that's when I will start to really feel that we are fully trying to dismantle and recreate a true equitable society. But in the meantime, you know, being able to have these conversations, you know, being able to talk about white fragility in a public discourse right now, and, you know, friends or in family and individuals having conversations at their dinner table about how they didn't even think about race unless it was somebody of color, right? So the fact that we're having these new conversations very publicly is extremely exciting. The fact that, you know, when the march, the protests started and the marches started, that when I went back to my community in New Jersey, where I was the only Black girl, that they were having a Black Lives Matter march. You know, for me, that's what gives me hope. A hope of a community that was over 80% white suburbia, who is the high school students are leading a Black Lives Matter march. So for me, I feel like this is a generational fight. Every generation has made progress forward. For me personally, I want to see more conversations around the way that the economic opportunities institutions are created for people across this country to be more equal. That gives me hope, but I also just have to have hope because I have a 5-year-old son, and his life is going to be hopefully better and different than the life that I grew up in. And so I have to be hopeful, not only for him, but the thousands of girls that we serve. We are, you know, promising them greatness and a future that they can be great in. And we have to do our work to be able to get them there.